Hello everyone, this is Sudhi here with another video. Today I'm going to show you how to get a free website with hosting and free domain. In this video, I'll be building a fully functional WordPress website for a coffee shop that doesn't exist anywhere. And I built a website like this without paying anything. Yes, it is 100% free. This website is using only the free resources available in the WordPress, and the images used in this website are from a free online stock image repository. This website is hosted with a free hosting service provider, which I will show you in a bit. And finally, it is using a completely free domain. This is pretty much a basic website. It has got a cover photo, and as you scroll down, you can see different sections with beautiful images and a contact form at the very bottom. There is a home page menu pointing to different pages within the website. This beautiful logo. I will show you how to make similar custom logo for your business. Whatever used in this website is free. But keep in mind that you are getting a free hosting service. In return, their logo will appear at the bottom right corner of your website. If you don't really mind about this, let's build one straight away. If you like the video, please support and subscribe my channel. Thank you. Let's start with two websites, freenom.com and 000webhost.com. Freenom.com is for getting free domains, and free website hosting is from 000webhost. In the documentation page, it has mentioned the free hosting allows you to build a few number of websites with a bandwidth limit and a storage limit. What does that mean is you can't store a big website in the free hosting service, and also because of the bandwidth limit, the performance will be slower than the premium hosting service. The free domains from freenom.com is restricted to few TLDs, which means you can't get .com domain for free. The TLDs available are .tk, .ml, and etc. as per the documentation. And you don't have to pay anything for buying these domains. Make sure you renew your domain and keep a website hosted to keep using the service for free. We start with creating an account with 000webhost.com. As I already got an account, I will sign in with that. To get the free domain, you need to search for your required domain in freenom.com. In this case, I'm going to create a coffee shop, and I'm searching for 24x7coffee.tk or .ml, whatever available, I will take it. So 24x7coffee.tk is available, and I have selected. When I check out, you have options from 3 months till 12 months. Every year you need to renew the domain manually within the last 14 days of next renewal. At checkout, you don't have to pay anything. Just hit checkout and wait for the confirmation. After confirming the order, click on services, go to my domains and choose your domain and click on manage domain. From the management tools, you need to update the DNS server details. In this way, your domain will be pointing to 000webhost.com. To set up the hosting, go to 000webhost.com and click on free sign up button on the homepage. After logging in, you can click on the create new site on the top right corner to start building your site. The website is created as a subdomain from 000webhost.com, but we can link your domain straight into that, which I will show you in a bit. Enter your domain name and a strong password and click create. It will take you to the dashboard where you can see the WordPress menu to install the WordPress. Go ahead and click install and put in the admin username and a strong password. In my case, I am putting admin as a username and a strong password. It will take a couple of minutes to complete the installation. When you see the success message, go ahead and click on the configuration button. Then click on the tools and set web address. It will take you to a page where you can point your actual domain to your hosting. So go ahead and click park domain next and enter your free domain address. Now if you go to your custom domain, it will tell you page not available because it's pointing to the hosting provider, but still it's not pointing to a web page. We will fix that now. Go back to tools and click on manage and link the website to your current subdomain. After finish loading, go to a website and see it should have a WordPress basic website loaded. We will now start working on customizing the actual WordPress website. So go to WP admin page and log in using your admin credentials. It will take you to the dashboard. The default WordPress installation will have a lot of unwanted plugins installed that we need to remove manually before we start. So we will do a cleanup first. Remove all the posts, remove any default pages, then go to settings tab and change the address pointing to your actual domain. You may update the email address to a professional email address based on your domain, something like info@yourdomain.com or .tk, whatever, and hit save. You will now need to log in again because of the URL changes. Log back in to the dashboard using your admin username and password. Then go to plugins. We need to add a plugin to upgrade your SSL. We are installing SSL just to remove that not secure label on the address bar. Go ahead and search for really simple SSL and install it and activate. After activating the plugin, you need to click activate SSL. It will take a couple of hours to reflect secure label in the address bar. Now click on appearance on the left hand side and go to About Shapely and go ahead and click Import Demo Content. It will install a couple of other plugins too. After importing the content, if you refresh your home page, you will see a beautiful website. Now we need to customize this using some good images downloaded from an external stock image repository. We will now prepare some images and the logo for the website. To download the image, go to unsplash.com. As this is a coffee shop website, I am searching for coffee and coffee shop, and I started downloading few images from Unsplash. To create the logo, we use a Google Graphics image and we will edit that in a web application called Canva. Go ahead and download a suitable graphics. After downloading, you need to open a new tab and go to canva.com. This is where we edit our logo. Here I am signing up with my Google account and skipping all the further notifications. Go ahead and click create a design and put custom size. When you see the canvas, you can click on the upload option on the left hand side to upload your graphics you have downloaded from Google. Then you can put a title, ask for your website name, and you can play around with the styling options available. Keep in mind, some options are only available for the premium account. There is a tip to create shadow for your text. You need to duplicate your text and place above the actual text with a different color. I will show you in a bit. I am repeating the same steps to create a bar which is a little bit bigger than my current image. So I created another heading and duplicated that same thing over with a different color. It looks pretty good. I'm happy with this design. I'm going ahead to download the PNG image from the menu option. As you are using the free version, it won't allow you to download a transparent logo, but it's okay because our header is white in the background. Now click on Customize and go to Site Identity, and we can upload the downloaded logo file to the website now. You may adjust the height and width of the logo if you require. Click on Publish to save the changes. Then we will start creating the menu. Click Create New Menu and name it as whatever you like. In my case, I'm putting Main Menu. Now we will add pages to the menu. In my case, the front page should be the home page, and there is a blog page that is already created. I will add a couple of other pages, Contact Us, About Us, and a gallery page. And you can add custom pages as you wish. After making all the changes, you need to click Publish to save those changes. Here, my homepage label was front page. I am updating to home. Now the header section is complete. We'll have a look how does it look. It's pretty good. Now we need to change all the images to coffee shop based images. Let's start. Click on Customize to go back to the dashboard. Now click on Widgets, click on Home Page, and choose each section one by one to update the image. As it is a repetition, I'm gonna fast forward this video for a bit. Now we are doing the last section of the home page. We'll remove all the other bottom sections because we don't need the branding section underneath. Click on Publish to save the changes. Now the last thing we need to configure is Contact Us form. As the default form plugin installed was Kali form, we need to remove that and install Contact Form 7. After installing and activating the Contact Form 7, go to Contact and choose your contact form, and you can customize the contact form there, but I'm just copying the code over to the widget. Go to the Customize tab again, Widgets, and update the contact form to Contact Form 1. Now if you save and publish, refresh your web page to see the changes. Go to the Customize dashboard again and choose footer option. You can update footer information set to your website information. Since the intention of this video to show you about the free website with free hosting service, I'm not going to show you how to edit all the WordPress customizations. There are thousands of videos available on YouTube. I hope this video is helpful for at least a few of you. If you like this video, please support and subscribe my channel. Thank you.